My parents wanted Māori names for us, but at the time they made the decision that we were born into a New Zealand that wasn't quite ready for those names, that it would be difficult, that people would struggle with it.
My first name is actually Matthew, my middle name is Hamuera, and my last name is Williams, but I go by Matthew Hamuera.
Ko taku ingoa tuturu nei, I runga I taku uru whenua, ko William, Tāmati, James, Rimene, Sprout.
Ko Aroha tōku ingoa, and ko Camille is my Pākehā name.
Engari e mohi o tī ānau, e tōku whānau, o tira e te iwi, ko Tāmati, Rimene, Sprout.
My whānau who I grew up with, my mum, still calls me Scotty. Brothers and sisters call me Scotty. But then I have this Māori language family as well, and they all call me Te Manahau.
My name is Te Rauheringa Brown, but the name on my birth certificate is Crystal Lee Brown.
There are some who know me as Sam, some who know me as Wiremu. To me, they are both my name, and I use them interchangeably.
Matthew is a transliteration of the name Matthew, but for myself, it was bestowed upon me by Kaiāwhina when I was at primary school, who would call me Matthew, and she was adamant that no, your name's not Matthew, it's Matthew.
I decided to use my ingoa Māori when I had begun Takiura and was in full immersion te reo Māori. That safe space, I guess, just gave me the kaha and the encouragement to whakamana my ingoa Māori, so I was fully supported to do that and I'm so glad I did.
Sir Timothy Karetu got up and was doing a bit of a sermon that night, and then he said, we've also had a meeting, all of the tutors here at this kurereo, and we've been discussing a Māori name for Scotty, because Scotty hasn't got a Māori name, so we've come up with one, and we've all decided that because of his cheerful disposition, we'll call him Te Manahau.
Two very good friends of mine, Hania Douglas and Anipiki Tuari, had a bit of a wānanga because they got sick of people calling me Kirito, Kiritori. So they came up with a name that best described me as a human being, as a soul, as a person. And so they came up with Te Rauheringa, big energy, contagious energy, vibrant energy. And yeah, when they gifted me that beautiful name, I cried. I cried.
My nan, my koro, it was that generation that were beaten for speaking Māori and so and not using their, not wanting to use their own gifted Māori name. So I'm just guessing that's just a passed down trauma.
I think in 92 when I was born, she was a part of that lost generation that never got given te reo Māori, that didn't have access to te reo Māori, and their parents chose not to give it to them because of colonisation.
When I was an adult, I decided to reclaim the name Matthew.
I started using Wiremu a lot more when I moved overseas and realised even people who had never been exposed to te reo Māori were perfectly okay with this name that I was always told was difficult or hard.
Matthew I felt really connected to because of my Māoritanga, my reo, and my journey to finding my whakapapa and understanding my whakapapa.
So when I returned back to Aotearoa, I felt a lot more comfortable introducing myself as Wiremu and not having to use my easy name for the sake of others.
The only person who ever called me William was my grandmother, my Scottish grandmother, but outside of that, outside of her, everyone knew me as Tāmati. So growing up, my name was Tāmati, and it was actually
Cheers, William.
Cheers, Scotty. Yeah.
My mum and my dad were both very accepting of the decision that I made to embrace my ingoa Māori. My mum cried, in fact. She got quite emotional because she didn't have the mātauranga to give me the name that she thought I deserved.
It makes me happy for my nan who was beaten, who didn't use her gifted Māori name until a long time later in her life. And her name is beautiful, her name is Ngārui. And for years she used Lui.
To be honest, if people call me Crystal, I don't kick up a fuss. You can call me Crystal, you can call me Sis, you can call me Te Rauheringa. But when I get up to introduce myself, ko Te Rauheringa Brown, tōku ingoa.
It's part of reclaiming identity, I guess. And you know, English names sometimes have just as beautiful stories behind them as Māori names. And sometimes transliterating an English name into a Māori name makes them feel more comfortable in their skin.
It feels more me, it just feels more me. It's a funny thing to explain, I get quite emotional, yeah.
When I first started out in broadcast as a reporter, I had a conversation with some of my senior colleagues about using Wiriwu as my name on broadcast. They counseled me not to, that Sam was easier. I'm ashamed I didn't use my name back then.
So how does it make you feel now when you come back and everyone's encouraging you to use it?
It's awesome. That's really cool. Yeah.